Jameson, are we good to go? We're good to go. All right, so it is traditional in the start with an L&N whistle, and on number two is an L&N break three chime whistle. So this is a whistle that would have been heard here in Ravenna every single day that the Steamboat motors were running. And as we go through the whistles here, I'll try to announce each one. As long as our numbers stay in place, they might melt away. So with that, Philip Johnson's son is going to take the reins here, and we're going to start with the L&N break time. That is actually off the Delta Queen riverboat. On number four, we've got a Central of Georgia five-chime whistle. If you're old enough like me to remember the movie Fried Green Tomatoes, this is the whistle that the steam locomotive wore in that movie. Number five is a three-chime whistle, early southern whistle that actually was off the Kentucky and Tennessee number 10, Mikado, which is now at the Tennessee Valley Railroad Museum. On number six, we've got a Baldwin three chime. On number seven, we have a 5-inch Lukenheimer. On number eight, everybody knows Norfolk and Western number 611. This is a Hancock three chime off of a Class J, belonging to Tim Entry, former vice president of CSA. And then finally, on number nine, we've got a three chime Crosby, belonging to Bo and Brenda Brown, from outside Greenville, South Carolina. So we'll kick it off from there. And the walk of shame. Just imagine if anybody's been to Key West and across the bridge, that coming across the Florida Keys and hearing that sound. That's what you would have heard from the Florida East Coast Railroad. explanation on how whistles work. If you notice, the sound on that elegant whistle was a little crisper than the first time. As whistles heat up and expand, they get crisper, sound a little bit better. And here we got Tim Hensley coming up. Tim lives in thank you. next year we're going to get an audiologist to sponsor this. Well, notice the similarities between the two whistles. I think the boys in South Louisville might have taken a Nathan and had a couple of drinks and copied it and made that 295 whistle. Let's give them credit. Nick Hogan.
Oh! hand grenade.
Number two, we have a Southern 5-inch Hooter whistle off of early Southern Railway steam locomotive. That's the 8-inch whistle on. On number four, we have another Southern Hooter whistle that belongs to the Holden family from Pennsylvania. Number five, everybody will enjoy this one. This is off at Louisville and Nashville passenger locomotive. This is an elevated passenger whistle, which has been used on their Pacifics and just their Pacifics. But they are a little bit taller and a lot nicer sound than the freight whistle that we heard earlier. Number six, we have a Buckeye 3-inch whistle. That will be here towards the end. On number seven, we have one of the most unique whistles. It's a Victory 5-chime whistle. It is part of Rail and Road Auctions. Barry Thomas, ladies, everybody. Barry Thomas, everybody. Rail and Road Auctions is running a promotion to sound it before you buy it. So this whistle actually will be available at the end of the month, at the end of October. For purchase, but you'll get to hear what it sounds like first on number seven. So that's a 5-chime whistle. The unmarked whistle on number eight is a 6-inch Crompton from an antenna factory in Rockport, New York, but that'll be a good old sound whistle. Finally, on number nine, we have another Crompton 6-inch. The original Providence is believed to be Kansas City Southern. This whistle once was owned by the late Brian Mayer of Ohio. It is now owned by Brian Nicodemus an actor in Indiana. And if anybody wants to go bowling and have a little project, don't do it with Brian. This man is a professional bowler, literally a big one. But everybody say it with Big Lebowski.
Thank you.
how cool could they be, you know?
Yeah.
the rival railroad making some good noise.
Yeah!
Davidson? Let's all thank Jameson Pond, everybody, for coordinating the other side of the ring. Teachers are keeping the fire going. All right. B06 chime on the first slot. We've got a Burlington 5 chime. On slot number 2, we have the Southern 3 chime freight whistle off MS4 Vacato number 4817. On slot number 3, we have another Southern 3 chime freight whistle. On slot number 4, leaking all the steam, is the NSW Hooter whistle. Brass top. Slot number 5, we've got a Lima 5 chime. Slot number 6, we've got Mason Young's Howl. Slot number 7, we have another NW Hooter belonging to Bo Brown. Travelers Rest, South Carolina. Slot number 8, the unmarked slot. We have a U.S. Army 5 chime. We left on the Reading 6 chime by popular demand, as well as the L&M Big Emma whistle. So let's get going. On the far right.
Thank you. We promised the local community we'd be done by 9. I think we're going to be close. So we'll get this ground swapped out. A couple of the favorites stay on. And, let's go.
Thank you.
giant pit.
Thank you.
everyone coming out. We appreciate all the sponsors tonight. Railroad Indiana Collectors Association, People's Exchange Bank.